there's a lot of new information coming out as we're learning more about the molecular mutations. And I think for all clinicians, it's challenging to figure out how we incorporate this at the time of diagnosis in terms of staging our patients, and then how we incorporate it into the decisions we make for them therapeutically. We're learning more about their function and their role in terms of drivers and passenger mutations as we move forward, and what defines various subcategories of our myelodysplastic syndromes. It's really helping us decrease the heterogeneity in this very broad disease group. And then certainly there's a lot of new applications with these mutations in terms of how we treat our patients and the next appropriate therapies. There's always new drugs in the MDS pipeline, and it's a lot of fun in that regard. Things that we'll be talking about and are most interested in are targeted agents. There's an IDH2 inhibitor. There's pembrolizumab or other anti-PD-1 therapies, which are very novel. And then there's spliceosome modulators that we're also learning about. We're actually going to talk about three cases, so very clinically relevant. The first will be using the mutational analysis of a patient from the time of diagnosis all the way through their need for a bone marrow transplant. And then we'll talk about, again, the new therapies in patients who might be erythropoiesis stimulating agent refractory, which is an area of great need and lower risk MDS. And then we'll talk about some of the other new drugs in higher risk or refractory patients. The How I Treat series is really beneficial predominantly to clinicians. It really takes a true clinical scenario and allows you a greater understanding and in-depth discussion than perhaps just reading the literature to hear from somebody who treats the disease on a regular basis, how to incorporate the novel testing and the novel potential therapeutic pathways. So I think it's really beneficial.